Time now for our Sunday morning Q&A. Joining us this morning, Senator Ben Cardin. Good morning. Nice to see you.
It's good to be with you.
We're starting off a week in Washington on a very sad note with what's happened with Congresswoman Giffords. Your reaction to this news?
Well, this was a real tragedy for our country. It was not just the Congresswoman. It's a whole nation that was victimized by what happened. You know, our democracy depends upon an open system, and this person jeopardized our system.
When Congressman Cummings was talking about her, he said, you know, she's tough, and if anyone could get through such a devastating wound like this, it would be her. What do you, can you tell us about her?
Well, Congresswoman Giffords is known for her frankness, for her, she's a moderate. She is a person of incredible strength. I agree with Congressman Cummings. I think that she will be tough through all this whole process, but remember, it's not just her. Mm-hmm. The other victims that were shot, people were killed. Innocent people were just coming to meet with her were put at risk. So this was a real tragedy for our nation.
Which brings me to another point here. She's been called a very conscientious legislator who was always holding town meetings. And something like this hits at the very core of what you all do, is working for your constituents. And she was trying to do this face-to-face.
Absolutely.
How does that process now get threatened?
Well, you know, our democratic system is an alternative to violence. You know, we change our government by the ballot box, by attending town hall meetings, by voicing your opinions. And that's put at risk when someone does what this person did. Mm-hmm. It affects all of us. It affects, so not just the congresswoman. It affects people who want to be able to talk to their congresswoman, just attending a meet and greet, and that person was at risk. Mm-hmm. I think all of us are at risk.
Mm-hmm. So what's the conversation you're having now with your colleagues and with your security experts about how you all, how congressmen and senators should conduct business? I mean, you need to get out and shake hands and speak to people and find out what their thoughts are. How are you going to travel now?
Well, I think we all have to be smart. We have to understand that there are certain risks. But again, it's not just the person, not just the public official. Mm-hmm. It's our society. It's all of us. So I think we're going to have to be smarter, and we're going to have to do things in a more attentive way. But we're not going to change our ways. Mm-hmm. We're going to keep our system open.
But you will have some more conversation about maybe taking some precautions, especially in light of, you know, we had these incendiary incidents here in Maryland and D.C. this week.
Absolutely. But one thing we can all do is just tone down the rhetoric. You know, let's be a little bit more civil. Mm-hmm. Words have consequences. And let's recognize that some of these really extreme statements that are being said are not helpful to trying to develop a more civil society.
Well, it was interesting. The sheriff out in Arizona was pointing to some of the rhetoric and the things that you're hearing in the media. He was heavily saying some of these anti-government rants are perpetuated through television and radio. We do hear a lot of these. There is sort of this sentiment out there. What needs to happen in this political climate?
I mean, well, I think we all have responsibility to recognize that our system depends upon an open, frank expression of views. We're not going to always agree on issues. Mm-hmm. That's fine. But we got to be civil about it. And although, you know, we sometimes say words that we don't really believe, other people listen to it. Mm-hmm. And it can motivate people to do extreme acts. So I think we have to be more careful.
All right, let's switch gears a little bit right here and talk about, you know, you had a new Congress seated this week. The Republicans are promising to repeal the health care reform. Is that just a big waste of time, or could something happen with this?
Well, look, the House of Representatives is going to pass the repeal of the health care bill. I think that's a serious action. If that were to become law, our seniors who just recently got more benefits to deal with their coverage gap for prescription drugs would lose that coverage. Parents who have been able to keep their children on their insurance policies now to age 26 would lose that protection. Those of us who have pre-existing conditions and have been discriminated against by our insurance companies would lose that protection. Our seniors who get a wellness exam now paid for by Medicare would lose that. And our national debt would go up by about $240 billion. That's serious stuff. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, the Republicans aren't suggesting to replace it with something. They're just saying, let's repeal it. Mm-hmm. I think it's an irresponsible act.
Okay. The president did make some changes in his administration. In December, you know, he made the compromise with taxes. Mm-hmm. We see him more in the middle. Is that something that's going to bid him well as he approaches the next
Absolutely. Years? I think what happened in the lame duck session is exactly how Congress has to to act. In health care reform, the bill was certainly needs to be improved, and we would hope that we could work with the Republicans and the Democrats or cross-party line. Mm-hmm. Let's improve the health care system, and let's deal with the other problems. Let's get our debt under control. Let's deal with our energy issues. Mm-hmm. Democrats and Republicans need to work together.
What about these changes that the president made in his administration? Sort of a, he didn't clean house, but he mm-hmm. sort of, you know, let some people left. He's got new people on board. How will this change things or help him?
Well, that's normal. You know, after 2 years, the president will normally shake up his cabinet a little bit. Obviously, President Obama is doing that. It will have some impact. Look, the people that are closest to the president have an impact on the way issues will be presented. I think he's looking for people who have experience, people who know mm-hmm. how to deal with a divided government. Remember, the House is under control of the Republicans, mm-hmm. the Senate under the Democrats, the White House, of course, President Obama. We all have to work together. And I think he's trying to put together a team that will be able to bring Washington together so we can deal with our national issues.
Is this the team? Is this a good team?
I think they're good people. Mm-hmm. I know the individuals that he's brought on board. They're Gene Sperling, for the economic person. He's well-respected on Capitol Hill. Mr. Daley is a very experienced mm-hmm. individual. Okay. I think he's brought some good people along.
All right. And the last thing, you are not in scheduled to be in session, but what's going to happen in Washington this week? Will anything, you know, what kind of week will you all have considering what's happened?
Well, I think because of what happened in Arizona, next week in the House is going to be devoted towards what happened in Arizona. You're not going to see any legislative business done next week. The Speaker has already indicated that.
All right. Thank you so much for coming in.
My pleasure.
All right. And
you.
Go Ravens, right?
Absolutely.